I just think that they might just, I think the senior players, it's the last game before they head off for Ireland camp. And I just think, I got quite a few texts from some of my former Ulster colleagues and, you know, giving out to me that I hadn't given enough credit. And maybe on reflection, Ulster were a little bit better than they thought they were. And they'll fancy their chances against Munster. And if Munster come out and give the same sort of lackadaisical performance with the amount of the error count, must have gone into the 20s. Mm. Unforced error account into the 20s. Ulster will take them. I'm not sure. I think Wallace will be playing, and I think Ferris will be playing. Mm. And they're huge. I mean, they won against, you know, the champion, well, the European champions without those two. And I think that was an achievement in itself.
Well, it was, and I mean, the old hunger and passion phrases are overused for years and years about rugby, but you sense that Ulster, they mightn't have the absolute equipment in terms of personnel, but you know when you see a team that really are enjoying it, they're enjoying being part of the squad, they're enjoying representing their jersey. Mm-hmm. I mean, I think it was Ian Humphrey's interview during the week, he said growing up, you know, he always saw himself and dreamed of playing in the red hand jersey as opposed to the Irish jersey, which was, you know, in his thoughts, but not as much. When he had his rugby dreams, it was about representing Ulster. And that's coming through thanks to McLaughlin and Humphrey's brother David, I guess, too. Well, they've reinvigorated that sense of pride.
No coincidence that suddenly Ulster are beginning to function. And the fact that they've picked an out half, they were, you know, oscillating between Niall O'Connor and you know, and that wasn't helping anybody, and particularly the team, because they do have different styles of play. And they've managed to cover, Humphrey's lack of defensive capability, because it is an issue.
But he has worked on it, too.
But they've two very, very clever. They've Pollock and they've Falloon, and they police it very well. They police that corridor. So if anybody does come down that channel, you know, they have it well policed. Their back row, too, are beginning to come to the fore. Ferris is, you know, and it's, we all know about Ferris, but Chris Henry last night and over the course of the season has played very well for them. And Falloon has come through. I don't think he's quite good enough yet to make a breakthrough. And I certainly think Pollock is a guy who, once he comes back from injury, will make a statement.
So, I mean,